Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to make a very very popular Odia dessert, and that is chhena poda. This is a dessert that all Odias die for. So let's start. The process of making this chhena poda is really really simple because I'm substituting chhena for some ricotta cheese, and we really need just 4 ingredients to make this very delicious dessert, and that is some ricotta cheese, some sugar, some cardamom powder and some semolina or suji. I'm going to begin by adding the ricotta cheese. I find using ricotta much easier, but if you don't want to use ricotta and you are using the normal chhena, then do ensure that you are mashing it well so that it becomes nice and smooth. But this is already smooth. Now to this I'm adding the sugar and the semolina or suji and a teaspoon of cardamom powder. I don't add any nuts to the chhena poda because I find that kind of ruins the taste. So all these ingredients and that's it. Mix it well. For this recipe, you need to ensure that the ratio of all the ingredients should be well balanced. For this recipe, I have taken 3 cups of ricotta cheese, 3 tablespoons of semolina, and about 1/2 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon of cardamom powder, depending on your taste, and about 2 cups of sugar. But then about sweetness, it's absolutely optional. If you want to make it very, very sweet, you can add about 1/2 cup of more sugar. When you add sugar, the mixture becomes very thin as the sugar starts to melt. You can see here the mixture is not very thick. It's just like a cake batter. This is the right consistency. I always add some suji in this recipe because once the semolina grains, you know, soak up the liquid or moisture from the batter, it kind of plumps up, and that makes this chhena poda very spongy. If you are using ricotta cheese and the ratio I have told is correct, then you are going to get the, you know, exactly the same thickness of the batter. But if you are using some chhena and if you find the batter a little thick, then you can add a little more water. Or else if you find it very thin, then you can always add a little more semolina or suji. So this is done. The mixture is nice and very almost like a cake batter texture. So this is ready. The next thing is to put in a baking dish and start baking it. Before putting the mixture to this baking dish, I have already lined it with a piece of parchment paper or butter paper, and I'm going to add just a little bit of ghee to it. I always brush the butter paper or the parchment paper with a little ghee just to give that added ghee aroma, but this is absolutely optional. The ghee is spread well. The next thing is adding the mixture. After adding the mixture, I'm going to smooth it a little. Yeah, this is done. Once the batter is in the baking pan, do ensure that you are covering it. It's important that you cover the batter before baking it, because once you put it in the oven without covering it, in that case the heat from the oven is going to dry it out. So the end result is that the chhena poda is not going to be very moist. And as I did before, I'm going to spread a little ghee on top of the butter paper or parchment paper, and then I'm going to cover it. Now put it on the chhena poda, and I'm going to just push it inside a little just that it sticks to the mixture. And since I didn't cut the paper quite well, I have some extra edges, so I'm going to trim it with a scissor. This is optional, but I do like it because I don't want the parchment paper to burn in the oven, so I'm going to trim it off. And don't worry about the steam not getting out because the edges still are little open, so the steam will still come out. I have already preheated the oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and I'm going to bake it for about 50 to 60 minutes. This is ready. I'm going to take out the layer of the parchment paper or the butter paper. Chana puro is completely cooked through and it's nice and moist, but still I don't have the nice dark golden brown on top. And in order to get that nice dark golden brown color, I'm going to put it back in the oven. But this time I'm going to put the oven on broil mode and I'm going to bake till the top layer is nice dark golden and brown. You can see here the edges are nicely golden and brown. It has a very sweet caramelized taste to it and a little bitter. But if you don't want this burnt caramelized edges, in that case you cover it entirely with aluminium foil before baking it. Just to ensure that the steam is getting out, you can make small pokes using a knife all around the aluminium foil and then you bake it. In that case you will not have these edges, burnt edges, and the top layer would be nice and moist without any color at all. So this is ready now. I'm going to flip it. For that I have taken a cookie sheet. Take out the lid. Take out this parchment paper. You can see the top layer is nice golden and brown but not very dark. But I know a lot of people, they prefer the top layer as well, a little golden and brownish, rather a little dark golden and brownish. In that case you put the oven on broil again and then you keep it till the top layer also gets the same color as the bottom layer. For me this is the right color, so I'm not going to bake it any further. I'm going to serve it as it is. I'm just letting it get completely cold before I serve it. This is very very delicious. I really can't wait to taste it. So definitely try this at home and don't forget to let me know about it. We will meet next time and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Till then, bye bye.